source in the governor's office tells us that they're looking at using general fund money if electronic pull tabs and bingo fall short. The governor wants that backup plan in place before the legislative session ends in just 12 days. No specific taxes will be raised, but they will identify using existing revenue. There is still hope that e-pull tabs, though, will take off. And there is a new game that's just rolling out. Our Jay Coles is live tonight in St. Paul at one of the bars where e-bingo just started 2 weeks ago. Jay?
Leah, this is what it looks like. You might not have seen it, but this is the e-bingo right here. It looks just like a bingo game, like you might expect. It's right here at Sherwood's Lounge on the east side. They're one of 73 places across the state that have these. Now, these are all linked up statewide to hopefully increase the jackpots. Now, if e-pull tabs can take off and e-bingo does well, hopefully it will pour more money into the Viking Stadium. At least that's what state officials hope. It's as simple as its name. Just match the numbers across, diagonal, or the corners, and you've got your bingo.
I think with anything new, they always want to try it.
Are you anxious to play it?
I am kind of anxious to play it.
But the key is to keep them coming back, and those that run the e-bingo say there is one thing that seems to keep people from dropping more money into them.
As far as the gambling part of it, it's a smaller wager.
And that means smaller jackpots until more people playing statewide can pump them up.
That is a drawback. It can take a long time to actually do anything. I'm just sitting and looking at a screen for a long time doing nothing.
Too early to tell how e-bingo will go, and right now e-pull tabs are not doing as well as originally thought. But there is one little joint that's playing big and helping the Vikings' new stadium drive more than others.
Yeah, and we're just hoping everybody else does, and it will pick up. I mean, we put our foot in right away because we knew it was coming and stuff.
Porky's on St. Paul's east side is routinely a top e-pull tab producer. Last month, a cool $57,000.
It'll stick around for a while. It will support and build this Viking stadium. Just give it a chance.
And now all eyes will watch e-bingo, and those who run it hope its simplicity leads to big dollars.
There's no errors. There's no yelling out bingo. It just does it for you.
And she's not kidding. With my short attention span and all my new best friends here at Sherwood's, I can tell you this. All you have to do is sit here at the bar. It'll take care of itself. It'll tell you when the game is over, and it'll also tell you if you're a winner, Leah.
All right, Jay. Well, you talked to a bartender who said there's still time for this to catch on. Do you think that's right?
Well, it is correct, because you got to remember, in October, when they break ground for the Viking Stadium, the Vikings pay that first $50 million. The state's going to sell some bonds around September, October. First payment on that isn't due until around January, maybe even February. So they got 7 to 8 months before it actually starts to get very critical. And they got to come up with some of this e-pull tab and e-bingo money by then, Leah.
So it could still catch on. All right, Jay Coles live in St. Paul. Thanks, Jay.